So, I've just got to Chongqing, and I love my bedroom. It's so nice. We're staying at a hotel that I've forgotten the name of. Ooh, but I like. And there's all these quirky, like, art pieces everywhere. Oh, and I have a bath. Fabulous. Oh, hello, me. Hi. Oh, very nice.
Hello, Mama Kim. I am in a supermarket in China. And I know that you like to go into supermarkets in different countries. So I am here to show you a supermarket in China. But so far, doesn't look that interesting. These are my friends. My old friend.
Hey,
baby. What's this?
It's your lunch.
Oh, lunch.
So you got seaweed, got you, fresh you.
Oh, that is so gross. Oh my god, they cooked tortoises here.
Which one do you want to buy?
No, I don't want any of them. Oh my god, I love goats. No, let's save them all.
Do you want to eat these?
No! No! I'm traumatized, David. We must buy all the tortoises. Save the tortoises.
Blueberries.
Oh, I love blueberries.
$4 for a blueberry.
Not too bad.
Yummy.
These are expensive.
What else do we have in here? So as you've just seen, they are selling live frogs to eat and also live tortoises. How horrible. It makes me want to become vegetarian and not pescatarian. Mm. Actually, the supermarket is very interesting. Almost lost my friends. So yes, over now. I know. All the right. Okay, so I accidentally made the mistake of telling people here that I eat fish, which evidently was a terrible idea. Because now I've been called to an aquarium! And now I've been told that if I don't pick something to eat, that is considered rude. And I have to decide which creature I want to be killed, which is like my worst nightmare. So as from tomorrow, I'm telling everyone in China that I'm vegetarian. And the people we're with now are currently watching me say this, but now no one speaks a word of English, so no one has a single clue what I'm saying. Please. I've just been brought to the temple, and it's in an awesome location because it's right on the bridge, and it's next door to these crazy towers that are literally leaning to the side. I hope they stay up. And now, to meet the Buddha. I'm currently at the very top of the temple, and the view is awesome. You can see for miles. This temple goes a very long way down. And I climbed to the top. Woo! Hello, Chongqing. This is Chongqing, China. From the top of a temple. And there's lots of prayer rooms here. And beautiful Buddhas. What's in here? Oh wow, there's loads of candles. I love Chongqing. It's so nice here. So pretty, like everywhere. And there's all these autumn like fancy buildings right by the river. I'm in the city center of Chongqing, China, by the monument, and it's so nice. I seriously can't believe how nice the city is. There's like massive buildings literally everywhere, and it's so colorful and vibrant. I'm currently in the center of Chongqing, and it's
so nice. It's like designer galore. And all the buildings are just like beautiful, and they go on for miles. This whole city is actually amazing. I never thought it would be this cool. I am now the biggest fan of Chongqing. Woo! Hey Chongqing, are you ready for this? Just when I thought the city couldn't get cooler, I ran into this building. I have no idea what it is. But I definitely want to go inside. Oh yeah. This is Chongqing. Stunning. Amazing. These are the lights of Chongqing and it just looks awesome. Apparently this city has the most bridges out of any city in the entire world and it really comes to life at night time. I literally can't get bored of Chongqing. I mean, look. I've just got to my hotel room in Yongchang, China, and it's so nice. Yay! Happy Sophie! Nice big comfy bed, all for me. Woo! Ooh, I like TV. Wow, it's so fresh. Hello. Chongqing to Yanchang.
Did you see the smoke coming out of my mouth? It's awesome. It's from these cool smoke things. Retro. This is the park kind of area where I found, which was like a long walk all the way down the motorway, like adjacent to it. And I feel so safe here. And if I run towards the road, you will see mountains in the distance. See, so pretty. So when I have more time to hike next time, you might find me up one of those big ass mountains. So I'm currently on a hike of Yongchang. It's actually so pretty here. Super, super warm. Blue skies. Actually, it's boiling. Sweating. But it's so nice. And I'm aiming for these big ass mountains. Hello, hike. I've just walked towards the mountains. Dang. And here I am now. So pretty. Now this is a very good location for a dance class. Restaurant, and we're about to eat hot pot, and you can basically go up to these freezers and take whatever you like and put them in your pot, and voila, the cooking session begins. And they have all these weird and wonderful things available. It's very cool, and everything's attached to a stick like a kebab. Dun, dun, dun. Okay, I thought I'd teach you the art of the chili hot pot. Now basically, oh, Sheshe! Lucy has found me my favorite boiled eggs, or miniature quail's eggs, I think they are. So basically, you go to the glass cabinet over there, and you pick what food you want, and every single item of food is on a giant stick.
Yo!
Yo! And then you put all the sticks into your cauldron, and this cauldron contains like chili oil and pure chilies. So, you then feel like you're dying for around 3 hours. Yep, that's right. Welcome to my world in China.
Welcome to China.
Woo! Peace. Check this. Woo! Awesome. That's crazy. I've just got to my new hotel room and it's so nice. It's actually massive. Dun, dun, dun. Ooh, giant TV. Oh yes, I like. And I have a walk-in shower. And a bath. Oh yes. And now I'm happy. When I'm taken to random places in China, I'm left with one question. Where the crap am I? China, baby. Whoop! I'm not so sure what's going on here, but there seems to be some kind of parade. There's so many children just literally walking all down the street holding bumps. is Chinese Kung Fu. This gal is amazing. Just when I thought the new city I was in was positively bleak, I discovered that I like it. More interesting now. We were driven to the top of a mountain today, and now we're about to have lunch. Woo! This is the second time we've been stuck in the mud. But we're back on the road. So beautiful. Wow. I have no idea where we're going. Life is a mystery for me in China. Wow! Okay, so you're probably wondering why I'm here. Quite a contrast from the five-star hotels I've been living in for the last month. Yep, but this is my room for the night. And no, I'm not in prison. Or am I? Basically, we drove for 3.5 hours. Oh my god, there's flying bugs all over the place. Okay, anyway, we drove for 3.5 hours to the middle of nowhere, up the mountains, and we got stuck in the mud twice, and then we fell in a ditch and someone had to come rescue us. And they drove us to a random mountain lodge. Oh my gosh, there's so many bugs. I cannot survive here. So yeah, where am I again? Actually, I have no idea where I am. Somewhere in China. I don't know where because we drove for 3 hours. But anyway, we were rescued and brought to this random lodge for dinner, and now I have to spend the night here. Yep. 5-star luxury, my friends. Wish me luck. Although, on the bright side, we've decided to turn it into an adventure. So now, someone has brought like a new car, and we're going to leave really, really early in the morning to go hiking in the mountains. However, oh my gosh, that's a big bug. The problem is someone just told me there's tigers here. There's more bugs in here. So I've just woken up from staying in a random mountain lodge after we got stuck in a ditch last night. And I'm here. It's actually so pretty. We're literally in the middle of nowhere. Quite crazy. Just like 4 cars we drove here with the lodge in the distance and the river.
Oh,
escalators, even outside in China. It's brilliant. It's pure genius. In
video,
fact.
Video. Hasta la vista, amigos!
My Mandarin translator right there, ladies and gentlemen. Goes by the name And now we're crossing the main road. A lot of people.
Ooh, what's this?
My life is now complete as I finally got to meet my panda best friend. Oh my gosh, she's so cute. Oh, I think I'm in love.